In CSS, you often end up in situations where you have to overwrite some code you have just written. For example, you create a list and you add margin to all your list items, but then you realize that you just want to remove that particular margin from the last item in your list. To do that, you create another selector, you target the last child, and you set its margin to zero. Well, there is actually a much better way to handle those kinds of problems, and that's exactly what I'll show you in this video on a few very practical examples that you've probably seen yourself many times. Let's dive in. Alright, I have created a demo and this should look something like a real-life landing page. I'm talking about CSS Weekly here with a number of projects that I'm working on. HTML is pretty much straightforward. We have a header with H1 logo, then navigation menu, and a main container with a section and a number of elements, number of headlines, and number of paragraphs within it. As you can see, I have applied some styling to the page. Even though everything works perfectly fine here, I'm going to show you how to improve CSS by actually removing a bunch of code and utilizing not selector to do that. Before we dig into that, I want to say that I wanted to showcase a number of real-life practical examples, and I couldn't really find a lot of those. So I asked on Twitter, and I got a bunch of fantastic replies by a number of people. I'm going to open this tweet right now. A link to that tweet is, of course, going to be in the description, so you can check it out yourself, and I strongly suggest you do it because there's a number of fantastic replies here. I'm not going to be able to go over all of them, but I will try to mention as many people that suggested some things that I'm going to be talking about in the video. If you're left out, if I somehow forget to mention you, I'm sorry about that. Thank you so much for sharing your experience. Thank you so much for sharing your input about the not selector. In any case, let's get back to the code. And first thing that I want to showcase here is how to exclude first and last items from certain selectors. We have this navigation menu here with a number of unordered list items, and each one of those list items has navli class. What we're doing here is we're adding margin right to each one of those items. We're actually adding margin inline n, which is a logical equivalent of physical property margin right. And we're actually adding margin right to every one of our items, including the last one. But as we want our last item to be aligned with the container here, we actually want to remove margin right from the last item in that list. Therefore, we're adding another selector, navli, that targets the last child. And all we're doing here is we're actually removing the margin we set just a few lines above. And this is a perfect example where you can utilize a not selector. And before I actually show you that, I want to say that if you notice that I should have used gap property here instead of margin right, you're absolutely correct. We wouldn't have this problem if we were to use gap property with flexbox, but I wouldn't be able to showcase exactly this problem. Therefore, I used margin right, and on legacy projects, you're probably going to find situations where flexbox is not used for navigation menus, and you're going to have exactly this example. I had it many, many times over the years, so that's why I wanted to showcase that. I will comment out this selector, and here I will create a not selector, and I will target last child. So what we're doing here is we're actually targeting all navli items except for the last child, and we're adding margin right to those items. So every one of those items will have margin right, except for the last child. Exactly what we want. So effectively, using the not selector, we've removed all of this code right here. So whenever you find yourself that you're using the last child or first child selectors to override something you've written, you might want to think about not selector and excluding certain properties in the first place. I will pull up my notes now, and people who actually mentioned this exact use case are Kevin Powell, and if you're watching this video, you're probably subscribed to Kevin's channel, and if by some incredible miracle you're not, then pause this video and immediately go to Kevin's channel, check out his content, subscribe to his channel. He's doing an incredible work and you should really be following him here on YouTube. Then Silvestar Bistrović also mentioned this technique, and he's actually written a blog post about this, and he calls this enabling CSS selectors and not disabling ones. I suggest you also check this article. And Mike Mai and Pablo Morales also mentioned this exactly same use case. So a lot of people are actually using this, and you should probably be using this as well. And before we go into our next example, we actually have another thing that we can tweak here. And we're dealing here with the headlines, and each of those headlines has border top set to this white line. On our headline selector, we're setting padding, margin, and border, and we're actually removing those exact same properties a few lines down. And of course, we can avoid that by using the not selector. So I'm going to comment out of this disabling part of code, and you're going to see that Right now, our first headline about CSS Weekly also has this border top, which we don't actually want here. And we can easily remove this again if we use a not selector on our headline and just add first child as an argument. There we go. And now you see that our first child or first headline doesn't have this particular border, but every other one has exactly what we want. And I actually don't even need this color right here. I don't know why it was present, so I'm just going to remove it. All right, this looks okay. And the second example that I want to show you is again related to headlines, and we're dealing here with the two headlines that are one after another. We have a headline H2 social media and H3 let's connect. This probably doesn't make a lot of sense. It's just here to demonstrate exactly the technique that I want to show you. What we're doing here is we're using the next sibling or plus to target headline that comes after a headline, and then we're resetting styles that we've added just a few lines before. And this is probably a little bit more tricky than the first example, because here we only want to target a headline that doesn't have a headline as a next sibling. So to do that, we're going to use not selector, of course. I will comment out this block of code. And we're going to extend our selector by targeting all elements that are not headline. So this will effectively select any element on the page that is not a headline. And then we want to have a next child that is headline. What we're doing here is we're targeting only headlines that don't have a headline as a previous sibling. So this will apply to our first headline on the page about CSS Weekly, and it will apply to our Let's Connect headline that we have right here. For this particular example, we actually still want to have margin block start set to -1 rem because those are a little bit too far apart. So we will re-enable this next sibling selector, and we will just uncomment margin block start set to -1 rem. This looks okay now, but still we don't have to override padding or border set exactly in the selector before. So if you have a number of elements that come one after another, then you can use not pseudo-class to avoid overwriting some of the code. And I think that Temani Afif is the only person who shared something along those lines in the tweet that I mentioned earlier. And I'm going to open it really quickly because Temani actually has a project, csstip.com, where he shares practical CSS tips. And there are actually two related exactly to not pseudo-class. One is where you select the first and last element with a class. You can see it here. And another one is how to select a range or how to select all elements between two class names. If you ever need something like that, now you know where to find those kinds of CSS tips. And the next example that I want to show you is how to exclude elements with a certain state from selection. In our example, we have this navigation here. And as you see, home menu item is actually in the selected state. So if I hover it, nothing happens. But if I hover other elements, then they're actually zoomed in a little bit and the color of text is changed slightly. In the code, I'm going to find that under nav a hover selector. And as we're changing color and scale, we actually need to overwrite exactly those properties on our nav a selected item. I'll comment out this entire selector. And you can see now if we hover our home item, it's actually zoomed in and the color of the text is changed, not what we want. So we will actually exclude this selected item from our nav a hover selector using the not pseudo class. And not argument is going to be .nav __a_selected. So this color and the scale will not be applied to that particular element. Let's try it. All right, scale is not applied, but we still have this hover effect where our text turns to white. And this is actually coming from our general a hover selector somewhere at the top. On a hover, we're setting color to this white. We actually want to exclude all navigation menu items from this a hover selector. And we can do that using the not pseudo class, of course. And we can target all .nav __a_items. And as you see, if I hover this item, everything is working as expected. So we were able to remove this entire block of code using the not selector. Another very good example for this is when you have some element that has closed and open state. So if you have some kind of a model dialog, let's say you have a class dialog, and by default, that dialog is actually closed. So you set something like display none. And then when the dialog is opened, you actually add additional class dialog dot is open. And then you say display to block. I don't have this particular element in this demo, so you're not going to be able to see it, but hopefully you understand what I'm talking about. By default, component is closed, and when it's in state of open, we actually change the display to block. But you can actually avoid this part of code if you just use a not selector and target all dialog elements that are not in state of is open. This will target only dialog elements that are not open, and it will actually hide them. Another example of using not to exclude elements when they are in certain state is when you actually want to highlight all elements that are not in, for example, state of hover. And I have a really nice demo for this. I'm going to open it right now. And I've actually created this demo for my other tutorial on practical use cases for has pseudo class. So check that tutorial. Link should be on the screen right now. The effect here is when I hover over one of the items, all the other elements, all other items are grayed out. And to achieve this effect, I'm using has pseudo class along with the not selector. So this is this selector right here. We're targeting UL element that has a link in a state of hover, and then we're selecting an A link of that particular list and targeting only A elements that are not in a state of hover, and we're changing their filter and color. So effectively, we're targeting only elements that are not in state of hover when one of the elements is actually hovered. Let's return to our original demo. So whenever you have a certain element in a certain state, like in a state of open, a state of hover, or anything like that, you can use not pseudo class to exclude that particular element from your selection list, and that way you can avoid creating another selector to override or negate the effect that you applied. And this is a use case that a lot of people have mentioned in the tweet that I've shared earlier. And I'm going to open my notes again. Daniel Yuschick, Álvaro Montoro, Lucas Bonomi, Christian Schaefer, Philipp, Rudolph, Martin, that goes by the name of Script Raccoon. And Martin also has a channel on YouTube. It's in German, so if you speak German, you should probably subscribe to Martin's channel. And Mark Boots, and Mark Boots actually shared the example that I've shown a little bit earlier, when you actually target all the elements that are not in a state of hover. So thank you all for sharing your use cases, your experience with not pseudo class. Another handy use case that I want to show you is to actually deal with the CMS generated content. Usually when people add something through CMS to the web page, that content, those HTML elements, usually don't have any classes. So for example, if you wanted to target all paragraphs on the page that don't have a class, because those will probably be paragraphs that users create, while the rest of the paragraphs that are elsewhere on the page probably have some kind of a class, so you can easily target them. Within the content, for example, you could target all paragraphs that don't have any class. And you could style those paragraphs any way you want. If I set color to yellow, for example, you will see that we're actually targeting all of our paragraphs on the page. And that way, if you're dealing with user-generated content, you can probably target all elements on the page that don't have a certain class. Maybe they're paragraphs, maybe images, or you can exclude those elements from your other styling. It might be something to look into if you're actually dealing with CMS-generated content. And again, on Twitter, a lot of people actually mentioned this particular use case, maybe not specifically that we're dealing with CMS here, but in general that you can exclude elements generally, maybe all elements that don't have a class, elements that have a specific class or something like that. And those people are Jacob Rask, Peter Raynders, Grace Snow, Stig Rick, Luke Schaefer, Stephanie Dubois, Romain Menke. I hope I'm pronouncing your names correctly. If I'm not, please correct me, and you have my sincerest apologies if I mispronounce your name. There's a really handy tip to use not when you're debugging to highlight all images on the page that don't have alt attribute present. As you probably very well know, old images should have alt attribute. It can be empty if image is just stylistic, but it has to be present. So if you want to ensure that all elements on a page have alt attribute, you can do that using the not selector. If you write something like this, we will target all image elements, but not those that have alt attribute. And we will set their outline 5 pixel solid red. Right now, I only have one image on the page, and this is CSS Weekly logo, and that image has alt attribute. But if I remove it from HTML, I'm going to do that right now, you should see that this element is highlighted with the solid border. So this is a nice little example of how you can use not to actually highlight certain problems on your page. And Steve Griffith actually shared this tip on Twitter. So thank you, Steve. So these are the tips that I wanted to highlight, but there's plenty more tips. So I strongly suggest you check out the Twitter thread that I mentioned, and make sure to, well, follow CSS Weekly on Twitter. And while we're at that, please follow CSS Weekly, or rather subscribe to CSS Weekly channel. It would mean really a lot to me. It doesn't cost you anything, but it would help me gain a little bit more visibility on YouTube, which will also give me an additional boost to create more videos like this one. Thank you if you do boop that subscribe button. And before you finish this video, let me share another example that Jeremy must actually share. And this is going to be on this tweet right here. I think Jeremy is the only person that shows how you probably shouldn't be using not. So this seems like a case where not has gotten out of control, where people keep adding and adding, or rather excluding and excluding more and more stuff from this simple selector. And the end result is something that is completely unreadable and completely ridiculous. This can probably be rewritten much simpler way. And well, if you end up in a situation like this, it's probably time to refactor that selector and to simplify it as much as possible. It's just a general rule of thumb in CSS and programming. Simpler is almost always better. Have I missed something? Do you have any good examples of how to use not or how not to use not pseudo class? Please share it in the comments or in the Twitter thread that I mentioned. I'll be really happy to read your examples, your use cases, your practical expertise. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I will not see and hear you in the next video.